Hello everyone, this is Srimoy. I am HOD, IMB department, Vijay Autonomous College. I welcome you to Odisha State Open University. Let's get into the world of marketing management. Here, I would like to discuss about a very interesting topic called Porter's Five Forces Model. This model, it is designed by Michael Porter. It is called as a tool, or it is a weapon. Through that, you'll be able to know that at which position, at current position, you are there. Because in marketing management, you consider the total market as a war field, and all those competitors, they are enemies. Before entering into any war field, you should be able to know about your competitors, your enemies, their strength, their weakness, the opportunities, the threats, and at which position you are standing now. It is very important. So Michael Porter's five forces, I can just list out all those forces, and they can be: number one, the intensity of the rivalry. It is the center one. It is the most important. How much intense it is. Later on, I will discuss in detail about all those forces. But before that, I will discuss the first, the intensity of rivalry, or you can say the competitive rivalry. Second force, it is a threat of new entry or threat of new entrants. Third force, it is the power of suppliers, or it is the bargaining power of suppliers. Fourth one is the bargaining power of the buyer, or bargaining power of the consumers. And fifth force, it is the threat of substitution. So again, I'm just counting. Number one, the intensity of the rivalry. Second one, the threat of the new entrant. Third one, the supplier power or bargaining power of the suppliers. Fourth one, the bargaining power of the buyer. And fifth one, the threat of substitution. And let's know the reasons for which all those forces can act. Number one, the competitive rivalry. Why this rivalry becomes so competitive or intense? You know very well, when market is very intense, you have to do number of things to make your product successful in the market. And one thing, when there are number of competitors in the market, then your competition will be intense. Number two, if the product is very common and it is widely used, as well as the manufacturer's numbers are very high, competition will be huge, as well as customers are very loyal. In low loyalty, they are just showing again, because if you have loyal customers, then competition cannot be so intense. That means customers are switchers. Whenever they see another product, they just jump. Another factor that really works, if there is a high cost of leaving market or making exit from the market, those competitors are bound to remain in the competition, then again, competition becomes so intense. Let's again, we go back to the next force, that is called threat of new entrants. Take the example, suppose you are standing first in your class. And suppose a better student or two to three students better than you, they just taken the admission into your class. Again, your position will go down. So that is the thing. When you are just enjoying the monopoly or enjoying the total market, that time some few entrants, they will enter. That time your position is in threat. And let us discuss at what condition those new entrants or new competitors, they make the entry into the total rivalry field. Number one, when The total field or the market is having no barrier, no barrier or low barrier to entry. Many of the companies, they will come, might be economic barrier, maybe non-economic barrier. So that time, again, your position in threat. Many of the companies, they will enter. Number two, when any other company, they are able to attain economies of scale, that means they're able to produce or manufacture the products at low cost, they will have the edge over you. And again, they are the threat. And when any field or any factor where new entry or exit, it is totally easy, entry exit is easy, then again, many of the competitors, they will entry and make the exit also. That time, again, it's a threat. Let's come to the bargaining power of the suppliers. Supplier, when they are few in numbers, they have more bargaining power. So when your business and number of business, they are dependent on few number of suppliers, the bargaining power of those suppliers will be higher. When supplier is large in size and they can supply huge number of clients, then that time also they will have the stronger bargaining power. And when a number of suppliers, they are dealing with a similar kind of products, again they will have the bargaining power. Whenever if you are unable to change your supplier, again the bargaining power will be higher towards the suppliers. And in case of threat of substitution means similar product can replace your product, like tea can substitute coffee or coffee can substitute tea. In that manner, substitution is also a threat. Like some of the cross product can be substituted, tea and coffee can be cross product substitution. That is also a threat. When some of the companies, they can have a similar kind of product with low cost. Again, your product in danger, because they can give the similar product to the market with less price. The last force, that is a bargaining power of buyer or consumer. And it happens when there are a number of large supermarkets. Customers are few, but supermarkets or offering market are high. That time, consumers or buyers will be a stronger position to bargain. Second point, if there is a cooperative among the customers, they're like you can know that those milk cooperatives. Why those milk cooperatives? Because they just make the cooperatives to make good deal. While if consumers, they have the cooperatives, then they can have the very stronger bargaining power. As well as if product available in the market is homogeneous in nature, then buyer also in a stronger position. And if customer is having no price sensitivity and economic condition is very high, then also in that case bargaining power of the customer or buyer will be higher. So I will discuss that in which condition the profit will be higher or lower. So let's compare high industry profit associated with weak suppliers, weak buyers, but high entry barriers and few opportunity for the substitutes, as well as where the competition rivalry, or you can say the intensity of the rivalry, is less. In that case, a company is able to earn higher profit. But at what condition an industry can really earn low profit? And those factors are if the total industry having strong suppliers, they have strong buyers, as well as there is less, or you can say low entry level by barriers or no entry barriers, and when there is many opportunities for substitutes, as well as when rivalry is very intense, there is less chance to get higher margin in the profit. So those are the things which really decides how much profit you can earn. And Porter's five forces model, it will let you know about your position, your strength in the market, and you will come to know at what type of war field you are entering into. So this is all about your Porter's five forces model. Thank you very much. God bless you.